Story points, a cornerstone of agile estimating and planning, but also a source of much confusion, not least for me. I didn't get them for the longest time, but now at last the mists are clearing. Welcome to Development That Pays. My name is Gary Strawn and welcome back to this mini series on the subject of agile estimating and planning. If you missed a previous episode and would like to catch up, you'll find a link here that should take you back to the start and deliver you automatically back to this very point. If you're all caught up, let's dive in. This is a map of the UK. Do you notice anything strange about it? That's hardly a fair question. I grew up colouring in pictures of this map at school. For those of you who didn't, this is a more conventional view. The reason that this version of the map is distorted is that it's not a map of distances. It's actually a map of time. The map represents travel time, more specifically, travel time from London. By the way, this kind of map is called an isochrone map, just in case you want to Google it for a map of your own country or region. The stretching that we see in Scotland and in the southwest and in parts of the east is a reflection of the fact that the transport system in these areas is less well developed, which I have to add is no bad thing. Would you build a motorway through this? For planning a trip, this map is excellent. I get to see directly how long it will take me to get to any point in the UK, with no nasty surprises, like the one I got the first time I drove to the Highlands of Scotland. I like this map a lot, but there are a couple of drawbacks to it that you've probably already spotted. This version represents travel time from, and I suppose to, London, which is great for me because I live in London. Not so good for anyone who lives, say, in Glasgow. They would have to have their own version of this map. There are potentially an infinite number of these maps, each with a distinct starting point. That's one problem. Another is that whoever produced this map made some assumptions about the mode of transport. Is this a map of travel times for car travel or for travel via public transport? The shape of the map would be different in each case, and it would be different again for walking or for cycling. So it turns out that a map of this type isn't quite as useful as it may appear at first sight. The conventional map turns out to be more useful, even though it doesn't give me directly the number that I'm looking for. What I want is travel time. What I get is distance. But I'm very comfortable with deriving time from distance, and I bet you are too. It's almost second nature to us to take a distance and transmute it into time. Let's do a quick demonstration of that. If I ask you how long it would take to drive from Paris to Brussels, chances are you don't have the first idea. But if I tell you that the distance from Paris to Brussels is 317 kilometers, which I think is just shy of 200 miles, then you're now in a much better position to take a stab at it. Here's another example of transmutation. If I ask you how long it would take me to type 5,000 words, you probably don't have a clue, and I don't either. But if I told you that I could type at a rate of 50 words per minute, I can't, but you know, let's just keep the maths easy. 5,000 words, 50 words per minute, I think that comes to 100 minutes. Words transmuted into time. So far, we've talked about distance and how we can transmute it into time. And we've also talked about a body of words in text and how we can also transmute that into time. Now, wouldn't it be useful if there was an equivalent to this for software development? Something that we could measure easily and then transmute into time. Trouble is, the things in software development that are easy to measure have some drawbacks. For example, it's very easy to measure the number of lines of code written in a certain period of time, or the number of new functions written in a certain period of time, or the number of commits to a source control repository in a certain period of time. All of those things are easy to measure, but these all turn out to be bad choices. In practice, when you measure the lines of code written, you get lots of useless lines of code. When you measure the number of functions written, you get lots of useless functions. And if you measure the number of commits to a repository, you get lots of useless commits. In any case, all of these things depend on code being written, which is a little bit late in the process. We'd much rather have something that we could use much earlier, specifically at the planning phase. Enter the star of today's show, the story point. Story points, as the name suggests, are used to indicate the size of a story, or if you prefer, a feature or a task or a general piece of work. Now, story points share some of the properties of the transmutable things that we looked at earlier. If one particular story or feature is 5 story points in size, then we can each apply our own personal transmutation. For example, I might think that I could complete the 5 story point item in 5 days. A more gifted colleague might think that she could complete the same 5-point story in 4 days. So far, so good, I hope. But now we hit a little bit of a bump in the road. You see, miles and kilometers, they are concrete. I don't think we'd have much of a discussion about the definition of a mile. It's very well understood, very well documented. When we say a mile, or if we say a kilometer, we both know exactly what we're talking about. As I said, they are concrete concepts. A story point, on the other hand, is an abstract concept. There's nowhere to go to look up the size of a story point. Turns out that that's not as big a problem as it might appear at first sight, and we will be getting into the reasons for that at the beginning of the very next episode. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this one, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your network, and hit the logo right here for a brand new episode each and every Wednesday. Look forward to speaking to you next time. Cheers for now.